I thank the distinguished representative of the federal
in Istanbul in 1996. The Millennium Development Goals, in addition to, had called for a significant improvement in the living of at least 100 million slum dwellers in the world or by the year 2015. The 21st century, as we are all aware, have been double the century of the city, with the more than half of the global population living in the town and the cities. Habitat II, the second United Nations Conference in Human Settlements, draw attention to the serious problems facing cities world over, especially those who are growing faster in the sub-Sahara Africa and our own South Asia. Increasing homelessness and the expansion of the substandard housing, inadequate employment opportunities, inadequate infrastructure, increasing poverty, a widened gap between rich and the poor urban population challenges. The policymakers in all over the countries, we are pushed to do more and better for increasing urban population wisely, with the same time harnessing the advantage of the urban living. In this scenario, it's very appropriate to discuss and deliberate on the theme that has been selected for this 25th session of the Governing Council, the contribution of the UN Habitat, the post-2015 developing agenda promoting sustainable urban development and human settlement. Mr. President, the Sri Lanka, often referred as the pearl of the Indian Ocean, has totally land area of 61,619 square kilometers. In recorded population of 22 million as in 2011, according to the national census. The population density has been estimated at 296% per kilo square meter. Sri Lanka has one of the slowest population growth rate, 1% annum, among the countries in the South Asia region, and the urban population growth, according to official statistics, average more 0.3% a year during period of 2005 to 2010. Therefore, urbanization scenario is a little different from the rest of South Asia. Government of His Excellency Maithripala Sirisena has launched a multifaceted program of balancing development. In this investigative program, human settlement and shelter development, especially management of urban growth, have been identified as the key area of focus. Sri Lanka has a unique pattern of urbanization and urban growth. The urban population, which was around 15% in 1946, has increased only up to 22% during the last seven decades, 22%. The moderate population growth rate, the modest urbanization trend, and the magnificent increase of the population residents urban areas are all results of the rural-based development programs actually pursued the implementation of the past few decades. However, the urbanization has now become a reality, an essential part of the people living as well as the national development efforts. After nearly four decades of internal conflict and uncertainty, Mr. President, the Sri Lanka has embarked on comprehensive development effort through the country. Accordingly, the government is actually promoting urban centers distributed among the strategic locations and development strategies in association with the comprehensive shelter and infrastructure development efforts. Mr. President, the Sri Lanka's is a basically home-owning society where the occupants themselves privately own 80% of the national housing stock. Out of total estimated housing stock of 5.9 million units, 81.7 have been estimated as permanent houses, 17.6 semi-permanent, and 7% are improvised. Therefore, the provision of the better shelter, improving the quality of the national housing stock, fulfill new housing requirement in future secure tenure, improving environmental infrastructure, and certain planning sustainable, healthy development condition of in each area of the major challenges that Sri Lanka has to address comprehensively. The new government of President Maithripala Sirisena is committed to develop sustainable human settlement development. This commitment is spearheaded by accelerated program to reach 50,000 homeless families with affordable shelter. This brave new effort, which has been launched under the 100 days program of the government, covering every electorate of the country, both rural and urban sector. The Sri Lankan program rehabilitate displaced housing schemes in the urban areas, incorporated community development projects to provide health and sanitation facilities in enhancing socio-economic activities, socializing all social economic benefits of the respective people. Mr. President, I represent a country which has been a forefront on environment, human settlement development activity during the last 4 decades or so. We are one of the first countries to commit ourselves to implement of the enabling strategy in human settlement development. We have played an active role in the deliberation of the agency with the UN Habitat for many years, and we are the responsible for mooting the declaration of the International Year of Shelter for the Homeless, IYSH 1987, and for the World Habitat Day, which was started from 1986. Therefore, we in Sri Lanka are proud to be associated with the new moves of the strategies development launched by the UN Habitat. The main challenges that all members nations face next decades through in the various instances will be how managed to develop human settlements in the urbanizing world in such a way of satisfy the social, economic, environmental goals, sustainable development. In meeting the challenges, we have to overcome limitations of the past human settlements policies, satisfy the growth demanding or democratic governing or the levels of the society. We as the Sri Lankan delegation to take this opportunity to invite to the member countries of United Nations donor agencies to make generous contribution and support urban and human settlement development efforts launched by the UN Habitat. Sri Lanka is process preparing the National Report of Housing and Sustainable Development for the third United Nations Conference Housing and Sustainable Urban Development Habitat 3 to be held in Ecuador in October 2016 through a process of consultation with the participation of the relevant partners. 8 Regional Estates Environment Sustainable Transport Forum in Asia held in Colombo, Sri Lanka from 19th to 21st November 2014 anonymously adopted the Colombo Declaration in order to demonstrate our continuous intention and reinforcement or reversal of the commitment promotion the low carbon transportation in Asia. During this forum, the existing Kyoto Declaration 2007 was endorsed and signed. Mr. President, distinguished delegates, to conclusion, I would like to express our appreciation and the preparation work of the Governing Council carried by Dr. John Claus and his team. We would like to also thank Committee of the Permanent Representative all in hard work, which greatly contributed to the preparation. I thank for your attention.
I thank the distinguished representative of Sri Lanka. I now call on the next speaker, the distinguished representative of Japan, Ambassador Tatsushi Terada.
Thank you, President. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, let me also express my deepest condolences to the victims and the families by the barbaric terrorist attack in Garissa. As many of us have already mentioned, that year 2015 has great significance in terms of sustainable development and international cooperation due to the packed schedule of the international conference. I'd like to touch upon the Third World Conference on Disaster Risk Reduction held in Center City, Japan last March. The conference was the biggest international meeting we've ever hosted. I thank again all for your participation and contribution to the adaptation of the Sendai Framework. That is indeed a great output for Japan as a country that has been promoting disaster risk reduction in the context of international cooperation. The government of Japan put significant importance on mainstreaming disaster risk reduction in order to build resilient society against disasters. The mainstreaming means to adapt disaster risk reduction into every development policy and plan. Therefore, we count UN Habitat as a valuable partner that has a strategic document with urban planning and risk reduction among the 7 sub-programs. We strongly hope that UN Habitat will further utilize the ideas embedded in Sendai framework, such as Build Back Better, in implementing the programs. Moreover,